be alone is to be in a state of revolution against the whole setup of the society.
Krishnamurti.
Society is not one thing. Society is the very substance of the conditioned mind. And it's very deceptive. I belong to a society of conservative people, and what do? I revolt. And then what do I become? Yes, I become a liberal. I become a... Till yesterday, I would say no, life has to be led in very secure ways, and conventions have to be followed. And these are the people who follow the conventions, and I am one of them. And I am one of them. And today, who am I? A liberal. And these are the people who really enjoy life, who give two hoots to tradition. And who am I? Who am I?
One of them.
And what have I done? I have revolted against the society. And I am not careful enough to see that I have only moved from one kind of society to another kind of society.
Like painting red, painting green too.
And look at the revolutionaries around. What are they doing? And look at your own mind. When you say that I want to revolt from something, all you want is to move to the other end of the duality, where another society exists. Where another society exists. So there is a boring society, and then you
want to go to the interesting.
Yeah, the adventurous society. But society is still there. What is society? Society is not something outside. Society is a mind that does not live in the self. Society is a mind that does not live in the self. Society is not other people. Other people would always be there. Other people are there for the Buddha also. He looks at them, he touches them, he talks to them. There are other people. But the Buddha is not social, because he does not have that mind. What kind of mind?
That seeks
security from others. Oh, I hate India so much. India is crowded, polluted, corrupt. And what do I love? I love the US. So all the time I'm talking of the US, even though I have never been to the US. But I love to talk of the US. How lovely. It's another matter that the US embassy will throw me away and not give me a visa. When I go there, actually, they won't even let me stand at their reception. But I love to talk of how the US is. And that makes me a revolutionary. India is stinking. All you want is to jump from one society to the other. Nothing else. Nothing else. You remember that? One does not wake up by switching dreams. One does not become alone by changing societies. I belong to a society of atheists. And then I belong to a society of the faithful. Whatever you do, aren't there others involved in it? And if there are others involved in it, how are you free from the society? By doing something. Do you understand the all pervasiveness of the society? How deeply it permeates? It is occupying every single fiber. It is coloring all the, even the minutest strands. If life is a fabric, then society is coloring it right up to its core. Everything is society. Everything is society. And rare is the man who can be truly alone. Truly alone. And of course, being truly alone does not have to do with people. Aloneness is not a function of other people. We are repeating, aloneness is a particular mind. Aloneness is a particular mind. And it is not as if that mind does not realize, recognize people. It does. Do not forget that aloneness does not exclude duality. Aloneness does not exclude this world. To be alone is to be fully of the world and yet alone. To be alone is to be fully of this world and yet alone. And then one has lived. You know what does alone mean? Alone means that society will not limit my spectrum. Society will not limit the zone of my existence. I can be here, I can be there. I can even talk to the stars. And I may not talk to the stars. Yeah, like a lotus, and sometimes not like a lotus. I am free to follow all the rules and free to break all of them. Complete unpredictability, not here, not there. Changing opinions is easy. Aloneness is not another opinion. I used to think that way and I now think this way, so now I am alone. I first used to be a party animal and now I love to live in my own room, so now I am alone. I used to think that life is wonderful only when you are living with your family, and now I curse the family all the time, so now I am alone. Aloneness is not a change in opinion. That is a very cheap kind of aloneness, and anybody can get it. Change your opinion. After all, they are your opinions. You have the exclusive rights over them. Change them anytime. And then you are alone. It's not that. Society likes those who are outside its ambit. When I say society, I mean a particular type of society. The Arab states would love Israel because Israel gives them a reason to stay united. Today all the Arab states are, when it comes to Israel, all of them are united. Iran and Saudi Arabia do not look at each other in the eye. They are very much at crossroads. But when it comes to Israel, Iran and Saudi Arabia are together. So society is actually nourished by those who are outside it. It's a great show. Good, nice, tamasha. These are the fake rebels. These are the fake rebels. You know, let there be a vast room in which all the action is happening in one corner and everybody is gathered there. And what do? You go and you set your small shop at the other extreme corner, the diagonal corner, and you say, I am a rebel. And that's a good way of attracting the crowd to yourself. That's a good way of attracting the crowd to yourself by acting a rebel. That is not aloneness. You are still related to that other corner. In fact, you are in that corner because that other corner is heavily populated. That's not rebellion.
Individualism.
See, individuality is meaningful only when you are talking of a highly influenced mind. Otherwise, there is nothing in individuality. In fact, religion is all about the dissolution of individuality. Individuality is ego. In fact, individuality is solid ego. Chaos is a amorphous ego. Ego that can be kicked around. But even in chaos there is individuality. The individuality of chaos says, I am chaotic. The individual says, I am an individual. Individuality is there in either case. Individuality means I am. Individuality means I am separate. I am one, I am indivisible, but yet I am separate from the rest. Within me there may be no divisions, but still I am separate from the rest. So if you have to really look at individuality, you will have to say that I am indivisible because space cannot be divided, because infinity cannot be divided. So real, mark this, real individuality is when there is no individual. Only then there can be real indivisibility. Otherwise, how can there be indivisibility? You are already divided. I am an individual and I am separate from the rest. Is there not division already? Division between what? Me and the rest. So what kind of individuality is this in which is resting on division? In real individuality, there would be nobody to be divided. So there would be no division at all, not only within myself, but in the total.
Complete inclusiveness.
Or complete exclusiveness.